ओके स्टूडेंट्स, टुडेज टॉपिक इज सरफेस एरिया टू वॉल्यूम रेशियो. फर्स्ट वी विल सी व्हाट इट इज, देन वी विल सी इट्स इम्पॉर्टेंस, वेदर इट द इम्पॉर्टेंस ऑफ स्मॉल सरफेस एरिया टू वॉल्यूम रेशियो और इम्पॉर्टेंस ऑफ लार्ज सरफेस एरिया टू वॉल्यूम रेशियो. वी विल सी इट बाय द हेल्प ऑफ डिफरेंट एग्जाम्पल्स. फॉर इंस्टेंस, वी विल सी व्हाट इमल्सिफिकेशन ऑफ फैट्स इज, how it is helpful or how it is important. Then we will see thermoregulation in animals. Thermoregulation means the regulation of temperature, the maintenance of nearly constant temperature in animals. You know that warm-blooded animals require to maintain their body temperature to a constant or nearly constant levels. How it is related to the surface area to volume ratio. Then we will see the impact of surface area to volume ratio on the rate of diffusion, whether it decreases the rate of diffusion or increases it. If we will increase the surface area to volume ratio, what it will do on the rate of diffusion. Then we will also see its relationship with the metabolic rate. Metabolic rate means the biochemical reactions that are happening in any organism. They are of two types, breaking down and building up reactions. In breaking up reactions, you know, larger molecules are breaking up into smaller ones. For example, proteins are being broken down into amino acid. This is a breaking up reaction. It is also called catabolic reaction. On the other hand, there are other kind of reactions which are called anabolic reactions or building up or synthesis reaction, in which smaller molecules join together to form a bigger molecule. I will repeat this topic again, but for now just remember that metabolic rate are the biochemical reactions, all the reactions that are happening in the organism. Let's see what surface area to volume ratio is. So it's literally telling you the meaning. It's a ratio between surface area to volume. This is a ratio between surface area and volume. And what it does, it affects the ability of materials to pass in and out of the cell. If you consider any animal cell, you know what it requires. It requires glucose, it requires amino acid, it requires oxygen. But what it passes out, what it excretes out urea, it excretes out carbon dioxide. So we see that there are certain things which need to go into the cell and there are certain things which have to come out of the cell. So this exchange is dependent upon the surface area. The surface area is related to volume in a way that whenever you increase the volume of the cell or any organism, its surface area would decrease. Now if you see this cube, it is of 4 cm each side. I have decreased its size to 8 cubes of each of 2 cm. So if you see that I have decreased the size of the cube, but I have increased the surface area to volume ratio of the cube. Now I have changed these 8 cubes into 64 cubes, each of 1 centimeter at each side. So again, I have decreased the size of the cubes, but I have increased the surface area to volume ratio. So as you decrease the size of the cubes, the surface area to volume ratio increases. This is emulsification of fats. What it literally means, it means that you convert a large fat molecule into smaller molecules. How it is done in your body? Whenever there is a big fat molecule, this is acted upon by bile from liver. Liver is an organ which produces a green alkaline fluid which is called bile. What bile does, it will break down this large piece of or large molecule of fat into smaller pieces. when you are decreasing the size of the molecule, you are actually increasing the surface area to volume ratio. You see, this was a big fat molecule. Bile broke down this big fat molecule into smaller pieces. If you see, gradually it is decreasing the size of the fat molecule into small fat droplets. As you are decreasing the size, the surface area to volume ratio has been increased. Why it is done and why it is important to be done, we will see the chapter of enzyme later on. But there is an enzyme which is called lipase. Lipase has a function of converting fats into glycerol and fatty acid. Fats are actually made up of glycerol and fatty acid. So whenever you eat fat, this cannot be utilized in your body until it is changed into simpler components, which are glycerol and fatty acid. This is done by the enzyme called lipase. So you see, first the fat molecule was mechanically broken down. It was physically broken down into smaller pieces so that its surface area to volume ratio would increase. And then the lipase enzyme can act on all the pieces very efficiently. Lipase would have acted upon this big fat molecule as well, but it would have not done that very efficiently. It would have taken a long time to convert this big fat molecule into fatty acid and glycerol. So you see, when you have decreased the size of the molecule, lipase is now efficient in its working. It can quickly convert this fat molecules into fatty acids and glycerol. So converting a bigger molecule into smaller one has increased the surface area to volume ratio, has increased the surface area exposed to the enzyme. Now this enzyme can act on all the molecules very efficiently in a very small span of time. It can convert these fat molecules into fats and fatty acids and glycerol. This is the next example, which is thermoregulation in animals. Thermo means temperature, regulation means maintenance, that you maintain the body temperature to near constant levels, and where it is required in all warm-blooded animals. Animals that are living in extreme harsh conditions, whether it is too cold or too hot, they need to maintain their constant body temperature. Like us, our temperature lies between 36.5 to 37.5. So our body is doing thermoregulation to maintain our body temperature to constant levels. Now, what is its relationship with surface area to volume ratio? You see, in the diagram, there is a big animal here, which is a polar bear. Polar bear are living in very extreme condition, very extreme cold conditions. What it requires to retain its body heat into its body. It does not want that its body heat would get eliminated into the environment. For that, it has to keep the surface area volume ratio to minimum. Always remember, the larger the animal, the smaller the surface area to volume ratio. Whenever there is a big animal, volume might be more, the size might be more, but the surface area to volume ratio would be less. Whenever the surface area to volume ratio is less, the heat lost by the body is less. That's what it wants. The polar bear is required to lose less heat into the environment so that it can survive in the extreme cold. For that reason, its body size is bigger, just like this droplet of fat. It was great in size. So is this polar bear. It is bigger in size, but its surface area to volume ratio is less. It is beneficial for this animal so that less surface area to volume ratio would be there and less heat would be lost by this animal into the environment, letting it to survive in the Arctic regions or north regions where there is extreme cold. Okay, now we have to see the relationship between rate of diffusion and surface area to volume ratio. We have read about diffusion, what it is. Diffusion is the movement of molecules from the region of their higher concentration to the region of their lower concentration. It does not require a membrane, it does not require an energy. Now we have to see the rate of diffusion. Rate of diffusion means the movement per unit time, movement of molecules per unit time, and what's its relationship with surface area to volume ratio. Single-celled organisms such as bacteria and amoeba, which is given here, can obtain nutrients and excrete waste simply by diffusion. You see the arrows are showing that nutrients can be taken into the cell and the waste material can be expelled out of the cell by simple diffusion. So the rate of diffusion is quite quick, quite efficient to let this animal survive, let this bacteria, in case of bacteria, it can survive, so that the requirement of that single-celled organism is fulfilled. On the other hand, multicellular organisms such as mammals, insects, fish require a more specialized transport system. We have blood circulatory system, we have digestive system, we have excretory system. Why it is important to have these transport system? It is because of the fact that the larger the organism, diffusion rate is so slow that it cannot let the organism survive on simple diffusion. It means the complex the organism is, the larger the organism is, diffusion alone cannot do the work. Alone, diffusion cannot provide nutrients to each and every cell. Because if you see our example, we see that we are made up of trillions of cells. Not all the cells here are exposed to the external environment. Our surface area to volume ratio is very less compared to this single-celled organism. We are more in volume, but our surface area to volume ratio is quite less compared to this single-celled organism. That's why this organism can survive only on diffusion for intake of nutrients and excretion of waste products. On the other hand, multicellular organism cannot survive only on diffusion because diffusion rate in larger complex organism is so slow that it cannot enable us to survive on that slow rate of diffusion. So what we learned here is that larger the surface area to volume ratio, quick would be the rate of diffusion. More efficient would be the rate of diffusion. If you are complex, if you are multicellular organism, if you are made up of many cells, diffusion rate would be so slow that it won't be sufficient to provide each cell with nutrients or sufficient enough to take out the waste products. That's why we have specialized transport systems. For example, circulatory system, blood circulatory system, excretory system, respiratory system. All these systems are there in complex multicellular organisms because diffusion rate alone cannot provide us with sufficient glucose, sufficient amino acid, sufficient oxygen, nor it can let us get rid of the waste products efficiently. Waste products in us comprise of urea, carbon dioxide. We cannot expel them that efficiently by just diffusion, because diffusion rate is slow because we have less surface area to volume ratio. Now, metabolic rate and surface area to volume ratio. If you see the diagram, I have placed a very small animal and a very large animal. Now, if you think the metabolic rate, the rate of reaction in this small animal would be much greater than this big elephant. Reason being, this animal's heart rate would be higher. All the biochemical reaction happening in its body would be higher. Its movement are higher compared to this big lazy elephant. So what is we are learning here, that surface area to volume ratio in a big animal is less since metabolic rate is less. On the other hand, surface area to volume ratio of a small animal is greater since metabolic rate is greater. Here in theory it is saying that organism with a high metabolic rate need more exchange to occur and so need a large surface area to volume ratio. So you are being told that this small animal has a high metabolic rate, so would require more oxygen, more nutrients, and would need to expel more waste material, more carbon dioxide, more urea, since it has higher metabolic rate. So its surface area to volume ratio should be higher compared to this animal, where the metabolic rate is slower, heart rate is slower, all the biochemical reaction happening in its body would be comparatively less. So surface area to volume ratio is also less. Surface area can be increased at exchange surfaces. Exchange surfaces means where the exchange of carbon dioxide and oxygen is taking place, or where the absorption of nutrients is taking place. For instance, villi in intestine, if you know the structure of villi, these are finger-like projections in small intestine. Why they are finger-like and they are making projections? To increase the surface area to volume ratio. So if you increase the surface area to volume ratio, you are actually increasing the rate of absorption. Absorption of what? Amino acid and glucose, vitamins, water, everything which needs to be reabsorbed in the villi, it needs to have greater surface area to volume ratio. What about other places, air spaces in leaves? You will learn the internal structure of leaves in transport and flowering plants. Then I will tell you how these air spaces in the structure of leaves are increasing the surface area to volume ratio. Alveoli in the lungs or gills in the fish, you would have learned about alveoli. These are the diagrams here. These are grape-like structures in your lungs, where the exchange of carbon dioxide and oxygen takes place. These alveoli have greater surface area to volume ratio. Greater the surface area to volume ratio means that they can take in more oxygen and they can give off more carbon dioxide. Same function is done by gills in fish. These surfaces are also thin to reduce the diffusion distance. Because they are thin, they easily dry out, so are protected inside the organism.